they are part of our communities representing as long as they are not on private Palestinian land. Of course, if they are on private Palestinian land, that then in that case we are favor of moving them to another location.
What is your relationship with Israel?
We have very good relations now with the Netanyahu government, as opposed to the Olmert government. Many ministers are strong supporters of Judea and Samaria. We have different of opinion with Prime Minister Netanyahu in the two-state formula. We think that it was a mistake when Prime Minister Netanyahu back in 2009 to adopt that formula. That formula is not attainable and it's not a solution. If a Palestinian state is established, then I can assure you that peace will not come as a result of that. On the contrary, most probably a new war will be initiated as a result of that. Therefore, we have people of opinion in Prime Minister Netanyahu very seriously on the opinion of that man. Yes, even when we have different opinion, we have a constant dialogue with Prime Minister Netanyahu. I myself voted Prime Minister Netanyahu in the last election. I personally have very close relations with the Prime Minister. I see him quite often. I advise him. Sometimes he accepts my advice and sometimes he does not, but that is the prerogative of a Prime Minister.
And what is your relationship with diplomats and ministers, prime ministers of foreign countries?
Well, we have. I have been engaged in the last 2 years in forming the diplomatic arm of our movement. Quite successfully, I must say. I have been in Washington lately and I have had meetings in the White House and meetings in the State Department. I have been in Brussels and had meetings with very senior officials in the External Affairs Service of the European Union. That is a new thing. That wouldn't occur a few years ago. That is a very, very important development. I cannot say that we have relations, let's say, with Secretary Kerry or with Baroness Ashton, but we certainly do with people on the most intimate level. So that gives us the opportunity to influence.
And are these formal relationships or rather informal?
Well, I don't know. We are not an official group. We are, of course, part of Israel and represented by our government. But I can tell you that those relations are cordial, are constant, are at very high level. Also, we prefer to leave them discreet in order to continue them without inconvenience. So we do not publicize that every meeting, but the meetings are at high level. And all the ambassadors of Europe and America, South Africa, Australia, and Israel, we are in constant contact with them.
You mean the ambassadors in Israel?
The ambassadors in Israel, yes. Just to give you an example, when I went to Brussels, to the European Union, my meetings were arranged by the ambassador of the European Union in Israel. So that shows you that they also have an interest in maintaining this relation. That was not the case a few years ago.
Can you this way influence somehow the boycott, divestment, sanctions policy?
We try. Also, you know, the European officials insist that regarding to Israel, not a settlement, it's not the policy of the government, but only private organizations. Regarding the settlement, it's an uphill battle, it's a difficult battle, but we saw, for instance, success with Australia. Australian government a few week ago announced that they will not use any more the term occupied when referring to East Jerusalem, to Judea and Samaria. Not also to Judea and Samaria, that was
said
by the ambassador in Israel. And that is, I suppose, also not only
of course, the power of the power of